All right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive studio. And joining us in studio is Dr. George Adams, the CEO of VentriPoint Diagnostics. And George, great to see you again. How are you?
I'm well, thank you. Thanks for having me back.
Yeah, so last time we talked, you were just in the process of putting together the next stage of your heart diagnostic system, sort of phase three of the machine. So tell me a little bit about what really is the game-changing phase three of your technology.
Right, so we've had two previous versions and we've put them in the several different hospitals, and feedback from the customer said there are two things that are make them not that easy to use. And so version three is now a breakthrough in terms of ease of use and size. So it's now a small portable machine you can take anywhere, and much more user-friendly. It guides you through the process, and it still has all the other features of the artificial intelligence-based analysis of the heart, of all four chambers of the heart. So it's a game changer for our ability to get the doctors to use the system.
Because they like the opportunity of playing with it and having it there and seeing it and doing all that kind of stuff, right?
Oh yeah, it's a game changer in the sense that, you know, our salespeople are going to take it with them. And they can set it up in the hospital right there for the doctor in 5 minutes, and they can hook it up to whatever 2D ultrasound machine there is there, and they can then start scanning patients right there on spot. And so a lot of them say, just leave it here.
Of course.
But it's really helping the adoption of the system. That was always been our issue about, you know, people loved it, but it's love what they got, the numbers they got out of it. They didn't know the fact that they didn't have to put patients through an MRI and spend 2 hours analyzing the MRI.
Right.
But it was a bit awkward to use. And so we fixed that in version three, and now it's very user-friendly.
So you have to get it recertified then through the health authorities, right? So where can you use your machine now?
Right, so we applied in June for Canada, Europe, and the FDA, and the US FDA, and so we got approval in June in Canada.
Nice.
We got approval in July in Europe,
okay,
and we're still waiting for the US FDA. We expect to have that in a few weeks. Even though we got the machine approved in Canada in the middle of the summer, we've already got eight machines, purchase orders for eight machines. We've already shipped out two machines so we have three children's hospitals and five cardiac centers in Canada who have ordered the machine.
Wow.
So that shows how the early adoption, and that's because we were able to go out and just show them how it works. And so the live demos really help. So that's, you know, I think we're doing very well in terms of the adoption curve. Europe, of course, we got approval in July in Europe. Europe's on holidays in August, so there's nobody there to demo anything. So we're now starting into the demo cycle in Europe. So I anticipate having, again, double-digit sales in Europe before the end of the year.
Is it, George, a lot of word of mouth? Is it people talking, like doctors talking to other doctors and saying, hey, we got this, you guys got to try? Is there a lot of that goes on in the medical community?
Well, there is a lot of that in the especially in the pediatric cardiology.
Right.
And you know, we started out doing right ventricle. Now we do all four chambers of the heart. And in fact, a number of the pediatric hospitals are using it to measure other chambers now, not just the right ventricle. But certainly the pediatric cardiologists all get together three or four times a year and talk to one another all the time. So, but still they want, you have to go there, hook it up, let them use it. I mean, even if their buddy Sam says, this is a great, really great thing I got, they all say, well, I gotta try it myself.
Right. So that makes sense.
Yeah.
You recently did a study was done at the Mazankowski Alberta Heart Institute. Tell me about the study that was done with the system.
Well, this is very interesting. The artificial intelligence system we use uses very sparse, what's called sparse data. So we only need a few points on a 2D slice through the heart to be able to reconstruct the heart correctly.
Okay.
And that's the magic of what we do. But often, about 20% of the time when you scan somebody, because you got to shoot the sound waves between your ribs, some people have very tight ribs, there's virtually no distance between their ribs, you get very blurry images, so about 20-25% of the time. And so then what they do is they inject contrast dye into you and do the echo simultaneously, and that increases the contrast between the heart tissue and the blood.
Right.
And so you can now get a couple of images that are crisp enough you can analyze. Well, most people, don't like have things in needles shoved in them, injected, and it takes extra time and it costs a lot more. The dye itself is expensive. And so we simply asked the question, you know, could you take those original images which were unreadable?
Yes.
And read them by our data, because all you do is find a little few pieces in any of the 16 normal views or slices through the heart, and we give the right answer. And so they did that study. And so they took the original real ones, they analyzed the original unreadable studies and analyzed them, and they did the contrast on the patient anyway, because they were going to do it anyway, and they analyzed that and they compared them, and they got exactly the same answers.
Wow.
So you don't need to, this is probably our toehold into the big, a much bigger market, which is the contrast media. About, as I said, about 20% of echoes require contrast media to be
usable. Wow, that's a big number.
Yeah, I mean, so that's about 8 million a year in the United States.
Incredible.
So that's about $1 billion business, right, that alone, just saying you don't need to use contrast media.
Wow.
So it's a big, there was a pilot study, they did 25 patients, I think, and so they want to expand it out to about 50 so that the correlation's perfect. I mean, it's just amazing.
So version 3 of the machine is more portable. It can be taken out to the doctors. You've got 8 purchase orders in Canada already. You're waiting for approval in the United States. What's this next 6 months going to look like for the company? It seems like you're really on a roll right now.
Oh, it's just sales. It's all about sales. Yeah, adoption. So the fact, you know, we're putting them in the major centers. Like you say, doctors all talk to one another. So they'll be going to conferences in the fall and in the spring, talking to all their colleagues about what they've been doing with the machines. They're all doing, not only doing routine clinical cases, but doing a little research project on all sorts of different kinds of patients. You know, there's, you know, thousands of different kinds of heart disease, unfortunately. And
sure.
So everybody has a special thing they want to do. So they'll all be talking, giving papers and talking about how good it is in different patient subsets. So that'll drive adoption even more. So we just got to expand. We built one of the other things about version 3 is we can make it ourselves. Version 2, we had a contract manufacturer. Version 3 is smaller, lighter, simpler, easier. So we actually created a manufacturing center inside our offices in Toronto.
Oh, nice.
That took about 6 weeks to get it audited and approved. So we can now build as many as we can sell. We can build them. So it's exciting times.
It sounds like it. Well, we look forward to having you back and learning a little bit more about how things go as far as sales are concerned throughout the fall. Great to see you again. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
All right, Dr. George Adams, the CEO of VentriPoint Diagnostics.